so much stuff for like friends and family, I haven't even bought a damn thing for myself.
Yeah, yet, I'm probably going to go broke by the end of the time I get out of here.
I'm saying. Anyway, we're going to get a restart here once again. PS2, me Brawler, going up against Wolf O'Donnell. And so far what I've seen from a steady diet of Ralphie is that he's just picking the right options to punish these laggy me Brawler options. Like whether it be, you know, he whiffs her on shield and there we go. So, Soaring Axe Kick is a fantastic out of shield option for me Brawler. It comes out really, really quick and it kind of has the same effect of like what Krom's up B is. You know, it just brings you up, brings you down,
right.
Good damage. The downside is that the recovery is awful. And that up smash really just sent you nowhere. As Baz is just kind of, you know, throwing haymakers right now. Wolf is such a dangerous character, you know, to hit on block against because he has so many fantastic out of shield options.
Right. And I mean, at this point with Ralphie just really doing such an amazing job of just mitigating all of his burst options, it seems like Spaz is really taking the brunt of his damage from just kind of like haymaker or just reaction options. He really kind of probably wants to calm down because it's very obvious that Ralphie is doing an excellent job of just whiff punishing a lot of his damage.
Yeah, he has Ralphie in the disadvantage right now, but again, just immediately giving up the stage position. The Flaming Side B, which name escapes me, I apologize if I don't know the name right there, but look at how much damage the head-on attack does.
Falling headbutt does so much shield pressure and damage. I mean, the one thing I would say, especially in this set, I feel like if Spaz really wants to take the momentum for this game, he's gonna probably wanna rely less on these literal YOLO options. Because that's the second time that he actually has done that Side B recovering back on stage just as to throw a hitbox out. And it got him back aired and ooh.
Oh, and it happened again.
He cuts the power with that.
What's going
on?
Oh,
my God. What happened? Well, that was definitely a definitive game one win.
Yeah,
you know,
that
there's
was
no
definitive
way,
game one win.
We're
this
no
is
way
stupid.
In any
right,
shape or form
going
to take that away.
What the hell's
but
going on?
All right. I'm sorry, guys. We're going to have to go offline again. And right. This is just dumb.
Hold on
we're going to have to be trying a little bit more thorough about this.
All yeah. Right. And no, Ryu from Street Fighter. Anyway, so we're getting started here in game two as we're going to see the boy Spaz switching to Pokemon Trainer.
Interesting choice, Vic. I mean, it's going with a really, really, really solid like switch up from, you know, Brawler. We're not talking about the general fighting archetype. I mean, yes, you do have a lot of malleability for it. You have Squirtle, someone who's going to be able to up be in your face, rush you down. Ivysaur is going to be able to zone you out and still make you really, really pay for those options. And then Charizard, which is literally...
Charizard. Is he, he's an up smash out of shield simulator. But
exactly.
Oh, that's
rough.
And he's a pinball wizard as he falls to his demise right there. And yeah, so I do agree that this counterpick's probably a lot better for Spaz, but I actually think Wolf's one of the characters the best at putting Pokemon Trainer in its place, because this character, I feel like, is kind of falling out of favor with a lot of people, but we'll see how it works out there, as that's going to go hella punished.
Yeah, unfortunately, just barely whiffs that Side B. I mean, I really thought maybe Nair from the last kill that he got probably might be a little bit easier, and I didn't know that that was going to be so much better of an option, but unfortunately, withdraw taking him off stage almost kills him.
See, both times he's lost stocks because he's done Side B the wrong way, and it's just resulted in death for him. So I don't think Squirtle's kind of the wave right now.
At all.
You see Spaz sticking with Ivysaur here. I don't know how much it's going to matter because this is definitely very much in a favor of Ralphie right now. He's just kind of going to do the fundies and... Okay, able to get back.
Uh-oh, using might have been able to put it back in his favor, but unfortunately not. I mean, Ralphie had pretty much the iron gates just set up for that ledge trapping situation where he was just not letting anything through, but a little bit of a change of the guard here. Charizard gets the reins and gets himself back into the neutral, but Ralphie looking to put that down immediately. Flare Blitz, desperation.
Nice parry to get the fly out of it, but again, just too little too late right now. But recovers high, okay. At least he's going down swinging. Maybe try to, you know, negate the three stock. That's kind of the game you're playing right now.
Yeah, sticks him with the oh my god, forward tilt so well placed. Three stock, quick 2-0 and a handshake, man.
Yep, just drop zone neutral air, finishes the job. Look at that, we got through a game.
Look at that, just
can I get claps in the chat, please?
Something, dude.
We're doing great. How many steps do I got, sir? I'm doing pretty